Morphin and Power Rangers, Issue 7, also known as Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, Issues 68 and 69. Both titles published by Boom Studios. Boom Boom! Boom. Starting with this video, mainly due to low viewership and low demand, we will be consolidating. We will be reviewing both Power Rangers and Mighty Morphin in the same video, instead of separately as we had been doing the past year. It will be easier for you and for me, I think. So, in Mighty Morphin Issue 8, we're finally introduced to the Seal Crystal. Yes, the ultimate MacGuffin in Power Rangers. The 2017 movie even revolved around the Seal Crystal. Mainly, Elizabeth Banks going to Krispy Kreme in search of the Seal Crystal. Now that's scary! As expected, Matt the Green Ranger and the citizens of Angel Grove are being weird. Mostly because Lord Sith had created a false utopia for them to uphold. So, it's akin to Stockholm Syndrome, rather than straight up brainwashing and removing their free will. Matt and the citizens of Angel Grove are willingly comfortable with Lord Sith being the ruler of Angel Grove, as long as they're safe. And that's why they try to reason with the Power Rangers to make them surrender. They were promised peace and no more monsters, as long as the Power Rangers surrender and turn in Zordon. It's a very complicated situation. It's still very annoying though, and kind of predictable at times. I'm not happy with the way the story's playing out. Elsewhere, millions of light years away, the Omega Rangers rendezvous back on Safe Haven, the former home base of the Blue Emissary. They realize after analyzing the remains and energy signatures found in the Red Emissary that the Imperials will be attacking an alien world that has been under totalitarian rule by some three-eyed aliens for millennia. The Rangers don't really have a plan, and it's very concerning. They come to this planet to warn everyone to evacuate, but Zack ends up doing something very stupid that really shows how contrived the plot has become. Basically, Zack tries to get the attention of the royals, but I don't like it. It really makes the Rangers look bad. And also gets the Rangers on the King's bad side. That felt like very lazy writing from Ryan Parrott. I'm very disappointed. And speaking of predictable, the King is arrogant, and the Queen is all woke, and she helps the Rangers. Ugh. It was a boring issue, very tedious to read. That's sad because so far, Power Rangers had been the series that had been anything but boring. That was Mighty Morphin. Oh well. Overall, both Mighty Morphin Issue 7 and Power Rangers Issue 7 were a disappointment. Well, Mighty Morphin was less of a disappointment. And it was Power Rangers that was boring and predictable and very middle of the road. I did not like them. But I guess Mighty Morphin was better. I also decided that come issue 12, I will stop reviewing both series until something interesting happens, if anything. So, final double verdict. Munch It for Mighty Morphin issue 7 and Slime Them for Power Rangers issue 7. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Au revoir. Night, night.